At ASCO 2021, it's my pleasure to present the results of a phase one study that we have done with a highly specific RET inhibitor. The compound is called BOS172738. It's an oral agent, which we tested in a dose escalation and dose expansion phase one study. The dose escalation has been completed, and this is what I'm reporting at ASCO this year. During the dose escalation, we included 67 patients with tumors driven by RET abnormalities. So either by RET fusions, as in the case of non-small cell lung cancers, or RET mutations, as in the case of medullary thyroid carcinoma or a number of other malignancies. We did a very conventional dose escalation. We escalated the dose of BOS172738 from 10 milligram to 150 milligram absolute dose in small cohorts of patients with advanced and highly refractory RET-driven malignancies. We assessed the safety profile, the pharmacokinetics, and early signs of antitumor activity in this trial. In terms of safety, the most common adverse events that we saw were increases in creatinine phosphokinase, but also dyspnea, facial edema, increases in liver enzymes, but also some anemia, neutropenia, and diarrhea. The drug was not associated with significant arterial hypertension or significant hepatotoxicity, which is an issue with multi-kinase inhibitors of RET as a target. The drug showed quite impressive antitumor activity. We saw objective responses in a variety of tumor types. The objective response rate, according to the assessment by the investigators, was 33% in patients with RET fusion non-small cell lung cancer and 44% in RET-driven medullary thyroid carcinoma. Interestingly, we also saw a complete response in a patient with RET-driven pancreatic adenocarcinoma. Another interesting finding was that patients with brain involvement who were allowed to be included in this study showed activity of the drug in the central nervous system as well. We saw shrinkage of brain metastasis in individual patients. Another striking observation was that some patients tolerate this drug for quite prolonged periods of time. One of my patients here in Leuven is still receiving the drug after being entered in the study about 659 days ago. The pharmacokinetic analysis showed that this drug has an extended half-life of about 65 hours, which allows maximum target coverage. So our conclusion from the current results of the dose escalation part of this study is that BOS172738 is a highly potent, very selective RET inhibitor that has significant activity in patients with RET fusion non-small cell lung cancer, in patients with medullary thyroid carcinoma, and in other malignancies. The trial is currently ongoing with an expansion cohort in specific tumor types. Here we focused on non-small cell lung cancer with RET fusion and medullary thyroid carcinoma, but we also have an ongoing cohort for patients with RET-driven other malignancies and for patients with NSCLC or MTC who had prior exposure to other specific RET inhibitors.